थर्ड आइसोमॉर्फिज्म दिया, इफ एस इज अ सबसेट ऑफ के आर नॉर्मल सब ग्रुप्स ऑफ जी, दैट मीन्स एस एन के आर नॉर्मल सब ग्रुप्स ऑफ जी विद एस इज अ सबसेट ऑफ के, देन वी हैव टू प्रूव के बाई एस इज एन ऑफ जी बाई एस एंड जी बाई एस बाई के बाई एस इज आइसोमॉर्फिक टू जी बाई के. सो वी आर प्रूविंग दिस थ्योरम बाई यूजिंग फर्स्ट आइसोमॉर्फिज्म थ्योरम. सो डिफाइन ए मैपिंग एफ फ्रॉम जी बाई एस टू जी बाई के by f of xs is equal to xk for x element of g. First we prove this mapping is well defined. For that, let xs is equal to ys for some xy element of g. Then by using the prop, then we have to prove f of xs is equal to f of ys. By using the property of cosets, we can have y inverse x is an element of s. Okay, the property is stated here, h is equal to bh if and only if b inverse a element of h. That is why y inverse x element of s. And since S is a subset of K, Y inverse X must be an element of K, so that we can write Y inverse X is equal to some K dash for some K dash element of K. Next, we are operating with Y on the left side of both sides. So Y into Y inverse of X is equal to Y K dash. Then we are associating Y inverse into X is equal to Y K dash. Y inverse is identity 1, so 1 into X is equal to this. X is equal to Y K dash for some K dash element of K. Next, we are looking at f of xs. F of xs is by definition xk, and we found that x can be written as yk dash for some k dash element of k. So replace this x by yk dash. So that is yk dash into k. Then by the property of cosets, it can be written as yk into k dash k. That is yk into, since k dash is an element of k, k dash k is k itself. This is a property of cosets. So yk into k, and k can be written as 1 into k, where 1 is the identity element. So again, by using as y into 1 k, that is y k, that is by definition of f of y s. Thus x s is equal to y s implies f of x s is equal to f of y s, hence f is well defined. To prove f is a homomorphism, okay, for that let x s and y s element of g by s, then f of x s into y s is equal to, by the property of coset, it can be written as x y into s. Then again by the definition of f, it can be written as xy into k. F of xy into s is xy into k. Then by the property of coset, it can be replaced as xk into yk, and xk is f of xs and yk is f of ys. Thus f is a homomorphism. Okay, by first homomorphism theorem, if f from g to h is a homomorphism, then kernel of f is a normal subgroup of g, and g by kernel of f is isomorphic to image of f. Okay, that is what first isomorphism theorem says. So first we look at kernel of xs element of kernel of f is set of those elements in g by s which are mapped to the identity in g by k. So set of all xs element of g by s such that f of x is equal to k. K is the identity element in g by k. And by definition f of xs is xk. So next step it becomes xk is equal to k. For by the property of coset it can be written as when xk is equal to k, then x is an element of k. Thus, kernel of f is the set of all xs element of g by s such that x element of k. When x is an element of k, then this set is k by s itself. Because xs is an element of g by s, where x is an element of k. When x is an element of k, it becomes an element of all the elements in this set is an element of k. So, this is k by s itself. Next, we have proving f is onto. If f is onto, then we can say image of f is full of g by k. That is why we are proving f is onto. So we are taking an element in the codomain, xk element of g by k. That implies x is always an element of g. That implies xs is an element of g by s. And so now we got an element in the domain g by s, that is xs. And next we look at the image of xs under f. So f of xs is, by definition, it is xk. Thus, when we take an element in the codomain, we get an corresponding element in the domain whose image is itself. So, since f is onto, then we can have image of f is g by k. Next, we are applying first isomorphism theorem. Since f from g by s to g by k is a homomorphism, first isomorphism theorem, we can say kernel of f. And kernel of f is here k by s. K by s is a normal subgroup of g by s. And g by s by kernel of f. So g by s by kernel of f is k by s. So g by s by k by s is isomorphic to image of f, and image of f is g by k. Okay.